So hi everyone, I'm very very happy to see so many familiar faces. As some of you know me, I'm Wissam, Rammo, and I was working in the LR on a Mars mission. It was before called Geophysical Monitoring Station, but now they decided to name it as Inside Mission. Because GMS was another astrophysics mission and they want to be something different. And since we see inside in Mars, they call it Inside. So Inside stands for Interior Exploration Using Seismic Investigations, Geodesy and Heat Reservoir. Okay, so let's go straight. So I'll just give some key dates. It will be launched in 2016, March, and after 6 months, we'll land on Mars, so it's September, until they decide to do it, the landing site will be near the equator. And so it will operate for 2 Earth years, as of or 1 Martian year almost. And if you look to the design, they use the same Phoenix design, the Phoenix Mars lander, which being 2007, because there's less risk and money and so on. So, and I will just give you now some. So what is the objective of the whole mission is basically to understand the inner structure of Mars, the structure composition, to estimate or determine the heat flux, the thermal state of Mars, and to investigate the tectonical activity there. And it's only one single Institute Geophysical Station. So it will be on one place, it will not move, not robots, only land there, and we'll measure wherever in the area. So, how to accomplish this science objective? There is different. The payload carries 3 instruments, and there is a seismic experiment for interior structure, SEISS, which is a seismometer. See here, and the RISE is will measure the time variation for Mars rotation. It's behind, so it's a spacecraft as a communication between spacecraft and the Earth, and we'll measure the Doppler shift. And the one I was working on, the third one, is the heat flux, the heat flow and physical properties package, HPQ. And I will speak about it now more in depth. So basically, it's this one, and which will. Yeah. Oh, okay. So, so HPQ control, like, it has 4 components. It had the support system, so which is like. Can see that, and basically it's secure the storage of all the other 3, the mold, the payload compartment, and the instrument tether. The instrument tether will measure it has temperature sensors, so it measures temperature, and the payload compartment will measure the thermal conductivity. And the mold is a mechanism, is a hammering mechanism, which will allow to drill inside Mars, interest Mars regolith. And the whole mission will drill like 5 meters, so it's the first time they are drilling so far. Yeah, so I have like short video which will show a little bit how HPQ will be deployed and how they will measure inside. The one support system is all, everything inside. So basically start drilling and then deploy the whole tether, which will measure the temperature and thermal conductivity balls that they go, yeah. So the 1 to 3 is like to make sure that the heat, like the from hydrogen that well, it's get heated, so we don't have inside the measurement, you know, because we have to be very, very precise. So it's fine. Then we can come after that. Sorry, yeah. And then so I mentioned we need both we need a thermal conductivity and the temperature gradient to measure the heat flux. And the equations, this is the Fourier law. And it's again like I'm just showing like how the whole thing's literally just inside. And now I finished actually. It was just a short presentation and I come to my summary. I'll just get the most important. So inside is very important for mission for like for understanding Earth-like planets. We only have two information about for Earth using either we have data of Earth and Moon. And this is the first time we have what we investigate like another planet, which would be Mars. The heat flow, the measurement is very, very important because it will give me about the thermal structure inside, what's inside the structure of Mars. And the future goal actually of the whole is not to build to have only one mission. Build a network around Mars, because the problem is when you have only one Mars on the Mars, we decide to take the equator region. But how representative is this? Is the number you measure? I mean, so you need actually a local unit over the Mars, a lot of this same mission, then you can do to estimate the values accurate, more precisely. Okay. And so I'll end up, and I hope you will have more questions, and so I can answer this.
What drilling mechanism are you using?
I told you the mechanism, the hammer.
Well, it's the hammer.
Yes, yes. So it goes like to 5 meters, yeah? Okay, yes.
How do you choose the location of deployment?
It's only decided from, I don't believe, but they decided to be at an equator. And I think, so what's your question now more precise? Why they decide to have it like on equator or what?
Yeah, so you said that the robot doesn't really move. It selects one location.
Yes.
And then you
yes.
make the measurement.
Yes.
How do you choose that location?
It's more like the people like from the science, you know, there's some interesting region. I think in the future is like the area, let's see, you need now the requirement, like to have it low risk, nothing can go wrong. There is, of course, like you need also to be, escape any, like you need to take places where there is no ice, or no depth, like, because the whole thing doesn't, like, it's 1.6 kilograms. So it's not heavy. If you like drill everything. So basically of the set of all the requirements, risk, the science, what will be inside, they decide to take the equipment. I'm not really familiar with this wider, especially like, but basically it's set the whole requirement, which is
so. Is the location predetermined, or do you make some sort of measurement while
you're working? So 2011, they didn't really know where we'll be. And I think now since 3 months, they know that they say like, okay, we take the equator. So it's not, it's they just like short term, they decide what the ones this way, you know. As I told, like, I don't really know in depth like why the one, but of course it has to fit like the whole requirement and then to make sure that the risk is low. And also the really interesting from scientific point of view, you know. It will be like from equator, you can really start and then you build that and then it will go out. Yes.
What information do you think you will find, or do you hope?
Yeah, for example, for the heat flux, we have already theoretical models, and usually it's expected to be the heat flux of Mars around 21 milliwatt divided to meter squared, which is the heat flux, yeah? So this is expected, and we decide to date 5 meters, usually 5 meters, because it shows from theoretical models it's enough that you can estimate the heat flux. And one very important thing is you need a seasonal cycle. You need to measure the whole year, Mars year, because you need to make sure that the, let's say, when sunrise, when the all the temperature, which is like underground, which is inside, you need to know them exactly, and then you can I mean, so can avoid them, and then you can like say, okay, this is only from the heat flux from Mars. So yeah, so from heat flux, we know exactly, like it's expected to be 21 milliwatt divided meter square.
And with that, you can
exactly yeah. So from the bell, you can see what is inside Mars from like the crust.
Okay.
Because the one thing is like Mars has a radius of 1,600 kilometers, but we know the radius plus minus 150. So the density, we have density uncertainties around 20%, right? You know, and we've like there's three instruments. I mean, we have a seismometer, which is very, very geophysical, is a very good way, the best way, because you send waves, then you can know what's inside. And we have this, the other one, the RISE, which will basically the wobble. You know, I mean, if you have, you can imagine like Mars will be like an egg. And because, you know, if the inside the core is liquid or it's solid, that means the tool starts to shake, right? And this is what RISE doing, right? You can measure this shifting and the heat flux. So basically using this three instrument will allow you to really know more in depth like what's really inside Mars, what the structure will be composed. You know, and, yeah.
But is it possible that you get a bad point? That
yes, of course. I mean, I think, yeah, I mean, it's been in the 70s when they were on the moon.
Huh?
They were doing also heat flux measurement for the moon, and but the angle was bad.
Okay.
And turns out they didn't really get like the values they get was not very, very, I mean, they were not precise. Of course, it has like the there is of course risk there. You know? If you have ice, my bells broke. You know.
Yeah. 2016 is pretty soon. How realistic is the launch date? Are you sure that it will happen, or what are the chances?
I mean, the one at. As long as the chances are, well, I mean, I left the project. I mean, I done the project now, I left like 4 months ago. So I don't, but I'm really sure that this date that they told me like 2016 and everything is now fine. So, because they are, like they are already now, I mean, the instruments are, they work very well. I mean, NES is doing the seismometer, they are already like in phase B, C, D. I mean, they are, well, we are also like quite very low. Like it's only depend now on GPL and NASA. But it has been accepted because this is actually NASA discovery missions, right? Now, usually there is different three missions that they apply, and one of them get accepted, and Mars just won't get accepted. So I think it's, it looks good. Hopefully, yeah. You know, space sometimes change, yeah? I cannot really tell, it looks good. More questions?
Okay, another question.
Thanks, wissam, rammo. I really like the project, and a special friend of mine at the DLR in Bremen, Hi Olaf, is also working for it, and he was really happy when this was selected for NASA and DLR and so on. And as a side note, in the German version of Wikipedia, the article for Insight is at the editing challenge for the next 3 days. You can still change it and alter it, and perhaps the editors will get even prizes. So just as a side note, and you can also do the editing there and do your Insight to Insight.
Insight.
Yeah.
All the way to everything.
Okay. Now we will come to the next question.